entitled A Warning, was written by an anonymous author claiming to be a senior White House official who calls Trump cruel, inept, racist, sexist, and describes working for him like this. Quote, it's like showing up at the nursing home at daybreak to find your elderly uncle running pantless across the courtyard and cursing loudly about the cafeteria food as worried attendants try to catch him. And that's the good part. Now, two things. First of all, this could be the deep throat of this administration. And number two, do you think, I know that Trump would like to know who it is so that he can go after him. I think he
or
should.
Or her. What makes
or her, that's right. Yeah. I mean, but there's so many people, who could it be, that who can't stand him anymore? Tillerson and even Giuliani now.
We don't know if they're still in the White House or not. That's
exactly.
The weirdest part about this, is that they still could be working in the White House.
Do you think he should come out?
I think it's incredibly cowardly to do this anonymously, and I think if you have this much umbrage about the person you're working for and the administration you're working for, then you should leave and you should come out publicly and go do an interview saying how bad it is, because for me, I don't know who this person is. They could be anyone with any vendetta in any way, and if you're still working in the administration, but you think he's a pantless, crazy person, how am I supposed to take what you're doing seriously?
Yeah, I'm totally with you on that. I'm really tired of trying to normalize things under the Trump presidency that we're gonna look in like 10 years from now and it's not normal. Like outing the whistleblower's name, I don't find normal, which is why I think we should speak out about that. But this is also not normal, because when you have a Democratic president that someone else is leaking stuff and not putting their name, the people that like this anonymous person is not gonna be happy at that moment. Mm-hmm. I think it feels very icky to me, and I agree with you, Megan. I think this actually helps the Trump administration, because it feeds into their narrative. Because if they're trying to bring people, if they're trying to get people against Trump, if anything, they're going to say, well, we don't even know who you are.
It's a long line of, I'm sorry, one second. It's a long line of books like Fire and Fury and books like this. We know this is a crazy administration.
Right.
There's actually nothing I've seen so far in any of these reports that's illuminating in any way.
But this is different.
Yeah, that you don't have the balls to come out and say it publicly. You're going to do it anonymously.
Fire and Fury was a reporter.
Thanks for the one clap.
Don't blame them. Fire and Fury was a reporter's book.
Yeah.
This is a guy who's a mole. I think he stays as a mole and keeps reporting. Well, I say stay there.
I can't wait for it to be a woman.
The thing is,
or her.
Right, could be a woman. The thing is, I mean, the whistleblower did the right thing by going through the appropriate channels, as opposed to, you know, going through the doing it this way or going to the papers. And look at what has happened allegedly to that person.
Yeah.
You know, you've got Don Jr. tweeting out the name, which, again, I believe if that person is retaliated against, that's a federal crime. I also think that you have the president trying to out that person. So look at the person that did it the right way, allegedly. Mm-hmm. And then you have this person who very, very well may still be in the White House doing it this way. And some of these allegations are incredible. He, you know, uses a fake Spanish accent during meetings to make fun of Latinos.
He's very racist and misogynist.
Racist, misogynist.
But how are we supposed to believe it if we don't even know who this
person
is?
You know it's true. Not believe it? Hello.